The Clifton Cultural Arts Center has hit its 5-year anniversary, and they're asking you to help them celebrate the milestone. Joining us to talk about it this morning is Cindy Herrick, president of the center. Thanks for coming in, Cindy.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
You too.
So tell us about your center. What is it?
The Clifton Cultural Arts Center opened its doors in 2008, September 2008, and we offer classes, performances, events, and exhibits. And in fact, since we opened, we've had more than 80,000 people come through our doors. So it has been a very lively hub of art activity.
Wow, and looking at all different kinds of things and all different mediums. I think we have a picture of something that we'll put up here, and you can tell us what it is, and then we'll talk about this event that you got coming up to celebrate. What is this we're looking at?
That is Flood Wall. That actually was our very first exhibit, which we held August 28th of 2008 as a memorial for Katrina. It was called Flood Wall, a Katrina Memorial, and it was debuted in the Midwest. It actually was 98 feet long, and it consisted of drawers that the artists had gathered when people who were hit by Katrina were going through their homes and through their debris and were throwing chests of drawers out.
I see.
And the drawers could be opened, and school children came and wrote notes to the people.
Neat exhibit. Now talk about this event that's marking the celebration. Golden Ticket Exhibition.
The Golden Ticket, yes. It's an annual exhibition that happens in September. It is for artists who live or work within 25 miles of the Clifton Cultural Arts Center. It's a juried exhibit, and this year we will have featuring the art of 66 artists. It occurs on Friday, September 6th. It is open to everybody, so please come.
Hey, you said you had all sorts of flavors of art, including
yes.
3D.
3D and sculpture.
Oil
painting,
and canvas.
That's correct.
Sculpture, neat. And will there be different categories, therefore, on the prizes, or is it, does everybody get lumped into one thing and you pick the ones you like the best?
There are categories, actually. Of course, the first and second and third place prize. There's also the People's Choice Award. So when you come, you get a ticket, and you can go around, and then you vote on what piece you are most enamored by, what you think is the best. And then there are also those individuals who have helped support the exhibit financially. That's the host committee, and they also get a ticket, and they can go around and vote for what they think is the best, and then those artists get awards as well.
And the pieces are for sale.
They are for sale.
Oh, yes. Sounds like a really great event. And you got a family-friendly event the next morning on Saturday. That is called what?
The Day of Celebration, to celebrate our 5 years. And for that, there will be a public art piece that consists of 1,000, really now we're up to about 1,500, Mylar flags that are screen printed with the wishes of CCAC for the next 5 years. And interestingly, that exhibit will be strung on the front lawn of the school, or the art center, we're in an old school, overnight. So as soon as the Golden Ticket ends, in the dark, people will be out there with tall ladders and lights, hanging the flags for the celebration.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. Thank you for coming in and talk about it. The Golden Ticket exhibit will be Friday, September 6th from 6 to 9. The next day will be the Day of Celebration in the center's front lawn from 11:30 to 2:30 with all those flags hung. Both events are free and open to the public. I'm sure they'll go well.